disciples devoted themselves with one accord to prayer with Mary, the mother of Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, whose only begotten Son, as he hung upon the cross, chose the Blessed Virgin Mary, his mother, to be our mother also. Grant, we pray, that with her loving help, your church may be more fruitful day by day, and exulting in the holiness of her children, may draw to her embrace all the families of the peoples. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Jesus had been taken up to heaven, the apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they entered the city, they went into the upper room where they were staying. Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. All of these devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women, and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has cast down the Almighty, the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has come up to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
Ascent because the people of God would sing these songs as they ascended to the high place of Jerusalem, to the temple. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Certainly that along with St. Peter on the mountain of the Transfiguration saying, Lord, it is good for us to be here. I think that those sentiments fill our hearts today as we can once again be here present to receive our Lord Jesus in the Eucharist. Just a couple of practical instructions. Many good thoughts have gone into the preparation for us returning to the celebration of the Eucharist together with safety in mind and with all of the things that we're being asked to do to protect each other from this disease, along with the seating, as you've experienced this morning, keeping the social distance, and we're asked to maintain that, and we shall do that. The other major difference that we will notice in the liturgy is that communion will not be given at the normal time. Rather, the Mass will finish, and then Father Barnabas and I will come down with the Blessed Sacrament. You'll notice, we'll come up pew by pew, but you'll notice the markings in the aisle that indicate 6 feet difference, especially when more of us might be here on the weekend as we come to communion to keep that line in the correct distance. You'll notice two tables up here in the front with bowls on them. In those bowls is contained pure alcohol, and our instruction for the safe reception of Holy Communion is that after each communion is given, Father and I will purify our hands in that pure alcohol each time so as to maintain the safety necessary for distribution of communion. We'll come down and remove our chasubles and place a mask on ourselves and then give communion there from the front. And we would ask you to come forward to receive Holy Communion, to receive communion, and then we will immediately exit the church. I'm asking people that, you know, it's always a bad habit you've seen through the years for people that receive communion and then leave Mass immediately, early, before it's over. But we're not doing it for that reason, to be in any way disrespectful, but to be safe. So I ask people to receive the Eucharist, and as you receive it, to make a conscious, reverent silence as you leave the church for a moment or two. Recognize that you carry with you our Lord Jesus present in the sacrament. Hopefully our hunger for that sacrament has grown intensely. And I think, you know, we look at this whole situation and we say, why do these things happen? We know that things that are not good happen, and evil happens in the world. And God never causes those things to happen, but he does permit them. And when he permits them to happen, it's so that a greater good may come from them. I'm hopeful and prayerful that one of the great goods that might come from this is a renewed sense and awareness of the precious gift of the Eucharist that maybe we just take for granted too often. And maybe all of us, you who are here mostly every day, and maybe even those who have become lax in the practice of their faith and have taken the Eucharist for granted, might have the opportunity to rethink that and to reestablish in us a deep appreciation and gratitude for this precious, precious gift of the Eucharist. We've been reminded that the Eucharist is not something we have a right to. It's something that is a gift to us of God. And we hold that gift precious in our hearts. And so today, let us renew our commitment to our Eucharistic Lord and rejoice that now, since really our patron feast day in March, we have not been able to come personally to receive that sacrament. But truly today, we rejoice as we come to the house of the Lord. We say with St. Peter, Lord, it is good for us to be here, to be able to receive you once again in this precious gift of your body and blood, soul and divinity. How beautifully appropriate it is that we begin the presence here in the Eucharist on this feast day of Mary, Mother of the Church, Mater Ecclesiae, Mother of the Church. And as I like to point out, this window right here is exactly that image of Mary. Below her, St. Peter's Basilica is on the stained glass. And to the left of that, the coat of arms of the Diocese of Allentown. We put that window in here in 1970 as the church was renovated. Mary, Mother of the Church. Pope Francis, in 2018, promulgated that this feast day, or as it is in the rest of the church, an obligatory memorial, be celebrated on the Monday after Pentecost Sunday. Hear the reading today, the first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, that our Blessed Lady Mary was with the Apostles on that great day of Pentecost, gathered together in prayer, and the Spirit powerfully came on them. She was in prayer with the Church. She's in prayer with us and present with us. And so we celebrate Mary, Mother of the Church. It's not just a memorial to the Diocese of Allentown, it's actually a feast day here because Mary, Mother of the Church, is the principal patroness of the Diocese of Allentown, which is why that window was put in here when the church was renovated in 1970. Mary, the Mother of the Church, we hear in the Gospel today that from the cross, Jesus entrusted the care of his Mother Apostle John. And he said to the Blessed Mother, "Behold her son." The church has always understood under the guidance of the Spirit that Mary was given to John as her mother. She was also given to the church, the entire church, as the mother of the church. We have been praying so much for her motherly intercession during this time of crisis in our world. And she has been praying with us to her divine son for her spiritual children as the mother of the church to intercede with the Father to remove this horrible disease from our midst. And I think today we should also pray through her motherly intercession for an end to the violence that we are witnessing in our country, the destructive violence. Certainly, everyone should be standing up for justice and always against anything that is harmful to anyone of any race. But the things that are being done, criminal things that are being done, the destructive things that are being done, are evil in the name of justice. We pray today through the intercession of Mary, Mater Ecclesiae, Mother of the Church, to pray for the removal of all hatred from the hearts of anyone that causes injustice and destruction, that causes bigotry, that causes us to not respect every single human life from conception to natural birth, to natural death. And so, we have a lot to bring before our Mother today, Mother of the Church, and ask her to continue to pray for us and with us to her divine Son as we honor her motherhood in the Church and we give thanks to Jesus for giving her to us as our Blessed Mother. Acknowledging
for Pope Francis, all bishops, priests, and deacons. May the Spirit draw them together to devote themselves with one accord to prayer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government officials, may God give them eyes of mercy and hearts of truth to seek the common good and care for those they serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, especially expectant mothers facing uncertainty or poverty, may God give them the grace they need to lovingly welcome their children into our world as Mary did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community gathered here in worship, may the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary help us grow in grace, fortitude, and fear of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, and especially today for Emma Ferriero Sr. and the Babilia and Coogan family, who we remember at this Mass. May all the angels and saints soon welcome them into the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those petitions we hold deep in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, dear, in answer to the prayers we make with one accord, we pray through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of his holy church.
Receive our offerings, O Lord, and transform them into the mystery of salvation, so that by its power we may be set aflame with the charity of the Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church, and with her may be united more closely to the work of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo our thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended
him, the host of angels, adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. And through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ.
Blessed are the apostles and the glorious martyrs, and we call the saints, for the apostles and the saints.
Savior's command, and forth by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be. As he hung upon the cross, Jesus said to the disciple whom he loved, Behold your mother. We pray now in prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us pray. Having received the pledge of redemption and of life, we humbly pray to the Lord that with the Blessed Virgin's motherly help, your Church may teach all nations to by proclaiming the gospel, and through the grace of the outpouring of the Spirit, fill the whole earth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The prayer back in the Roman pandemic. Most merciful and triune God, we come to you in our weakness, we come to you in our fear, we come to you with trust, for you alone are our hope. We place before you the disease present in our world. We turn to you in our time of need. Bring wisdom to doctors, give understanding to scientists, endow caregivers with compassion and generosity, bring healing to those who are ill, protect those who are most at risk, give comfort to those who have lost a loved one, welcome those who have died into your eternal home, stabilize our communities, unite us in our compassion, remove all fear from our hearts. Fill us with confidence in your care. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you.